Kissing Booth 3 is the end to the Kissing Booth trilogy on Netflix. It's no longer about kissing booths anymore. We've been duped. It's the summer before Elle heads to college, and she's facing the hardest decision of her life, whether to move across the country with her dreamy boyfriend Noah or fulfill her lifelong promise to go to college with her best friend Lee. Whose heart will Elle break? Welcome, movie watchers. Thank you guys for stopping by my channel. Kissing Booth 3 is the latest film in the Kissing Booth trilogy, and this is the end of it, thank God. I've not defended the Kissing Booth movies. People have regarded them as some of the worst films of that year. I just thought they were okay. Kissing Booth 3 is where I draw the line. This film, just from beginning to end, there's nothing redeemable about it. There is nothing I found interesting about this movie. It jumps from plot point to plot point so quick. The synopsis I just read to you about her trying to choose a college, does she go with Noah to Harvard or does she go to Berkeley with her friend Lee? That's the first 14 minutes of the film. There's so many different plot points in here that all do center around Lee, Noah, and Elle. It goes from her trying to choose what college, and then it goes to her completing a bucket list with her friend Lee. There's other love interests involved. It starts to focus on Elle's father and her father's girlfriend, and then there's Molly Ringwald's story at the end. There's just so, it just bounces around so quick. You're not able to kind of latch on to certain stories within the film because of just how brief they do feel. And it tries to make it as brief as it can, especially when it comes to like the bucket list scenes. It's just like a montage of things that are happening. So it makes some of these decisions, which should seem very tough for Elle, just not that hard. Like, it's just easy kind of conversations and decisions because they just all happen so quick. Especially deciding where she wants to go to college, Harvard or Berkeley. Those are big life decisions, and they just happen so fast. And with the pacing just moving so quick, you can't really get invested in any of the characters as well. From Lee, Noah, Elle, or Lee's girlfriend, or Marco from the previous movies. Everything just feels so quick that you just don't care by the end of it all. The film centers around nostalgia, especially for Elle as she's deciding where she wants to go to college, and she spends a lot of time at this beach house that she pretty much grew up as a kid with Lee and Noah. That's another storyline in the film, is dealing with selling a beach house and all the flashbacks that come to Elle when she was a kid with Lee and how their friendship is very important to her. Those, I feel like, are some more of the dramatic scenes within the movie, but it just feels like another separate plot point in the film that just feels very underdeveloped. There's some really good, I guess, singular storylines in here that could work if they were just expanded, taking a majority of the film. I think it could have worked. But instead, it's throwing this story and then this story and then this story at us. And it's like, it's all just coming at us all at once, and you just can't latch onto it. It starts to get a little bit repetitive about middle half of the film in regards to Noah and Elle's relationship. It's like constant arguments between the two, and then arguments with her and Lee. This all happens like before she's going to college. She should just be enjoying her summer with everybody, but instead there's a lot of arguing within the film, and it does get a little bit repetitive because it feels like it's like the same arguments over and over again, and like you heard it already once before. No reason to give it to us once again. By the end of the film, I could care less where she went to college. Go where she wants to go to college. I hope that she has a good college career. At point in the film, it feels like nothing's going to happen, though. It feels like she's not going to go to college, or she's going to completely change her mind once again. But it does end, I guess, in a satisfying way in regards to her story with Noah. But kind of leading up to that, doesn't feel like there's anything's going to happen, or she's just gonna disregard friendships. I kind of got that vibe towards the end of the film, and then it just wrapped it up in a way that I guess is pleasing for the character. I really could care less, but you know, I enjoyed the first two movies for what they were. They kind of disregarded the kissing booth throughout the last couple of films, but the third film for me is probably the worst one, with the amount of storylines that are introduced and how they kind of just bounce back and forth, and then the characters are just not interesting. They're bringing in several different characters to try to shake things up, and it just does not work. There's no like end to certain things, and bringing in certain characters is just there to shake up relationships. But really, do they need to be there? No, but they're there, and we're just watching it all unfold, and I really could care less. Disappointing end to the trilogy for me. Like I said, I not really defended the first two, but I'm like, hey, they're all right. The last one, no. I just could care less about pretty much everything in the film. So before I give you my rating for Kissing Booth 3, make sure to check out my channel down below. Here I do movie reviews, trailer reactions, first time watches, ranking videos, tier lists, all that fun movie related content you see on YouTube. I do it all here, so might as well subscribe to get it all in one place. I'm gonna go ahead and give The Kissing Booth 3 a C-. Thank you guys for checking my review for Kissing Booth 3, the end of the trilogy. Thank you. It's over. If you guys have seen it, what do you guys think about it? Let me know in the comment section down below, and stay tuned for more up and coming content. My name is Just Watches Movies, and you guys stay classy, YouTube.